Hello friends, myself Yogesh Bhavsar and I am working as an assistant professor in electrical engineering for KBT College of Engineering. In this video lecture, we will see the construction of DC machine. DC machine, it is a common term given to DC generator as well as DC motor. So when we see the construction of DC machine, so it is common to motor as well as generator. So here we can see the cross sectional view of DC machine. So different part we can see here, like the outer enclosure called the yoke. Over this yoke, this is the structure, electromagnets, which is called poles, and pole show. Again we can see the field winding over these poles, then armature internally, armature winding, then commutator and brushes. So these are all arranged in this machine. So let us see the function and the details of one by one what present here. First is a field system. The function of field system is to produce uniform magnetic field within which the armature rotate. So the field system main function is to produce the magnetic field. Whenever DC supply is given to these electromagnets or this field winding, it produces a uniform magnetic field. Hence it is called a field system. Now this field system consists of this outer yoke, then these poles and field winding. So this consists of the field system. There are number of salient poles, even number obviously, bolted to the inside of circular frame called yoke. So over this yoke, these poles are bolted, which are simply electromagnets. Yoke is usually made from cast, solid cast steel, whereas the poles pieces are composed of stacked laminations. So this yoke is made from solid cast steel. As it can carry the magnetic field, we can see in this another diagram. This dotted line shows the flow of magnetic flux. The field winding is wounded over this pole so as to produce the magnetic field. So here we have shown here the N pole, S pole, N pole, S pole. So alternate poles will be produced. The arrangement of winding is such that it will produce alternate poles. Field coils are mounted on the poles and carry the DC exciting current. Practically, the air gap between this field winding and the armature is 0.5 mm to 1.5 mm. The structure of these poles are like horse show. So it is called a pole show. So this will be the spreading like structure. Why this is? Because it will spread magnetic field inside this armature. So there will be the spreading of the magnetic field. That's why the structure is similar to the horse show. Right. Next we see the armature core. You can see the inside this field system, this internal structure, which is the armature winding, the commutator and the brushes. This whole structure is called the armature. The armature consists of a slotted soft iron laminations about 0.4 to 0.6 mm thick that are stacked to form a cylindrical core. So this is a structure. It is made from the soft iron laminations and which are stacked to form a cylindrical core. Inside this armature there are the tooth, the number of teeth there, and over these slots the armature winding can be wounded. We can see here the pictorial diagram. So this is the armature core made from the soft iron lamination over the shaft, and the copper winding is wounded over this teeth, and each winding end is connected to this commutator. This is called commutator for the shaft. The purpose of laminating core is to reduce the eddy current. Eddy current is the current which will be induced in this core whenever the winding carries current. So this core cuts the fluxes and EMF induces in the core which will carry the current. That current is known as eddy current. As we are not using this eddy current, we term as a eddy current loss. So to reduce this eddy current, the core is laminated. So this core will be separated from each other so that to reduce this eddy current loss. Lamination are slotted to accommodate and provide mechanical security to the armature winding and to give shorter air gap for the flux to cross between the pole face and the armature teeth. So this is the armature. So let us again we see the detail of this commutator. So before that, let us see armature winding. Now over this armature core there are slots, and in this slot the winding is wounded. Now this winding wounded is known as armature winding. There are two types by which we can wound this winding. One is called the lap winding, another is called the wave winding. The slots of the armature teeth holds insulated conductor that are connected in a suitable manner known as armature winding. This is the winding in which the EMF can be induced in case of DC generator. If it is a DC generator, then this is the winding where EMF will be induced. But if it is a DC motor, then we have to supply external current into this winding to produce the unidirectional torque. So as it is mentioned DC generator, so working EMF will be induced in the armature winding. The armature conductor are connected in series parallel combination to get the desired voltage and current. So there will be a series parallel combination of this particular lap and wave winding to produce the desired voltage and current. The armature winding of DC machine is closed circuit winding. So it is always closed circuit winding. The conductor being connected in a symmetrical manner forming a closed loop or series of closed loops. So this is a closed loop, as we can see, closed circuit winding. So these are the closed loops. Now the difference between this lap winding and wave winding, we can see lap winding, this is a commutator and this is a singleton winding. For example, this is a commutator segment 1, this is commutator segment 2. We can see here the starting of this winding, lap winding, from commutator segment 1 and the completing it turns. And the end of this turn is connected to the adjacent commutator segment, that is the second commutator segment. So this is called lap. So there will be a overlapping. So again this second will start here, it will come to this point here, here, and again it will connect to this commutator segment third. So this will be a continuous, so it is called lap type of winding. Now you will see the difference between this lap and wave winding. Wave winding is nothing but it is like a wave. So the commutator segment, for example 1, which is a starting point of this winding, but the end point of this winding is connected to the number of commutator segment ahead of this one. Here for example 8. So see, there is a lot of internal commutator segment are there. And another winding which will connect to this commutator. For example, some of the winding will come here and will connect and this continue to the next segment. Right? So this is called the wave winding. Now let us see the commutator. Commutator is basically a mechanical rectifier which converts the alternating voltage generated in the armature winding into the direct voltage across the brushes. So it will convert AC into DC. It is a mechanical rectifier. The commutator is made from copper segment insulated from each other by mica sheet and mounted on the same shaft. The armature conductor are soldered to the commutator segment in a suitable manner to give rise to armature current. Just before, practically I have shown you, this is the commutator segment. These are the commutator segment. Copper strips are attached to this shaft and insulated from each other with the help of mica insulation. So the end of this winding is connected to particular commutator segment and the brushes will slide over this commutator segment. Okay. So how it converts AC into DC? So let us see N and S pole. This is permanent magnet. In this permanent magnet there are two conductors, A and B. This is one side conductor and D, C. This is one side conductor, completing a coil turn. Now at this condition, okay, we have again connected here the commutator segment C1 and segment C2, and one side is positive, this side is negative. It is connected to external resistor. So whenever we have to collect this induced EMF to the outer circuit, we require this commutator. It converts AC into DC. Let us see how. Okay, so basically the DC generator also induces EMF in AC, alternating current, and this current is converted into DC with the help of commutator. Let us see, this AB induces current in negative direction and the DC current induces in positive direction. So at this condition, this C2 will be positive, C1 will be negative. After rotation, 180 degree rotation of this conductor, this AB becomes to S side and DC becomes at N side. But the induced EMF at DC is negative and the induced EMF at AB is positive. So that's why again this side will be positive, this side will be negative. Even though the commutator segments C1 and C2 exchange, but with respect to this coil also exchange. But the direction of induced EMF is same. So that's why this side is always positive, this side is always negative. So we'll see at the output DC, direct current, instead of AC inducing in the internally. So this is the function of the commutator. And last, the brushes. Brushes is ensured to collect electrical connections between the rotating commutator and the stationary external load circuit. So it will connect basically the rotating commutator and the external circuit. It is made from carbon and rest on the commutator. The pressure is adjusted with the help of adjustable spring. The number of brushes, as many as the number of poles. Suppose 4 pole machine has 4 brushes. So this is the carbon type of brush. The diagram is shown here with the help of this spring. So this is the commutator segment, and over this commutator segment these brushes are continuously sliding so that it will collect the current which will be induced in the armature conductor. So basic function of brush is to collect current from the armature conductor and it will supply to the external circuit. So this is the function of the brushes. So this is what the construction of DC machine. Hope you understand this. If you have any doubt, then you can connect. These are the references I have made. I have referred to make this video lecture. Okay. Thank you.